three-game road trip. Christian Laettner had 27 points last time out against the Terrapins. A similar performance today would be welcome. Maryland has lost two straight ACC games, including a heartbreaker against Clemson Wednesday night. This shot would have sent the game into overtime. It's the first time all season Maryland has lost two games in a row. Terrapin coach Gary Williams has been distracted this week with news about possible rule violations. Williams and his team will try to forget about that today and concentrate on Duke. Terrapin forward Jesse Martin is playing well and will be heavily counted on this afternoon. Today, two teams trying to bounce back, the Duke Blue Devils and the Maryland Terrapins.
Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports present the best in college basketball, the Atlantic Coast Conference. Today's game is brought to you by Budweiser, U.S. Air, Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company, Buick, First Union National Bank, Food Lion, and by Pepsi.
Live from Coldfield House in College Park, it's number four in the nation, number one in the ACC, Duke Blue Devils against the Maryland Terrapins. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Mike Hogwood, working along with Terry Gannon today. Terry, it has not been a fun week for Gary Williams and his Maryland Terrapins. The Washington Post reported that Williams has admitted to the NCAA that he purchased some clothing at reduced rates for athletes. Williams vehemently has denied that all week long, but he did admit that on October 15th, the official start date, before that, he was here watching a practice. Well, it's been a distracting time.
Well, I think it's affected us, to be honest with you. We, you know, you go through this year and you tell the players you don't want any distractions, you know, the things that are going on you can't control. And then some more things, you know, come out this week, and it's been very difficult. It's been tough on me to concentrate, I know, so it affects the players also. But, you know, we're playing Duke, and they've got a great program, and, you know, we're trying to change some things here and get to a point where we are considered like that. And so, you know, we try to face whatever we have to face and just move on and get the players to focus on this one particular game against Duke.
Well, there is a lot of emotion here in Coldfield House today surrounding these two teams. This entire atmosphere, emotion, a good word to describe it, Terry.
Yeah, I think so. Emotion will play a big part for both teams today. For Duke, the question is, can they come back after a late night loss to Virginia? They're on the road. It'll be tough. I think the first 5 minutes will tell a lot about their emotional state. And for Maryland, this place is hopping today. It's the one place they can get away from all the off-court problems and have some fun.
Well, let's hope they have some fun. I think we're going to have some fun watching a great basketball game. We'll talk more about Duke and Maryland from College Park in a moment. It's time now for the Mazda game plan, brought to you by Mazda Cars and Trucks. You know, it just feels right. Well, Terry, last Sunday against Notre Dame, Robert Bricky re-entered the lineup for Duke after that knee injury kept him out for 8 games. They were glad to see him back, I'm sure, but it also creates some problems.
Well, in terms of chemistry, I think it does. You know, chemistry is one of those things that you can't put your finger on. But I do know when you lose a key player like Robert Bricky, you have to make a lot of adjustments getting the chemistry. Then when he comes back, you have to adjust him being back. Yesterday, in a conversation with Mike Krzyzewski, he expressed a lot of concerns over just that, the chemistry.
It changes the roles of about four different people. And even it changes Hurley's role a little bit, because he remembers him filling the lane and running the break a little bit better than he can right now. Maybe 2 weeks from now, he'll be able to do that again.
Now, Terry, we talk about the Maryland Terrapins. Of course, talk about those big guys up front, Jerrod Mustaf and Tony Massenberg.
Well, you have to. That's the key for them. I mean, Massenberg and Mustaf, people get sick of seeing this two-shot right there, but they're the story. And in the first game against Duke, the Duke inside people dominated the game. These guys got to have a big game early if they're going to win.
We're going to have a good one, Maryland and Duke. Back with the starting lineups after these messages. Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon with you live from Coldfield House in College Park, moments away from the start of Duke and Maryland. Right now, let's go to Maryland Public Address announcer Nick Cavalakides for today's starting lineup.
From Coldfield House on the beautiful campus of the University of Maryland at College Park, here are your starting lineups. The Duke Blue Devils, from University Park, Illinois, a 6'4 senior, number 3, Phil Henderson. From Jersey City, New Jersey, 6-foot freshman, number 11, Bobby Hurley. From Clifton Park, New York, 6'6 junior, number 22, Greg Kubek. From Bloomfield, New Jersey, 6'10 senior, number 30, Ala Abdelnabi. From Angola, New York, 6'9 sophomore, number 32, Christian Laettner. And in his 10th year at Duke, head coach Mike Krzyzewski. The Maryland Terrapins. From Hammond, Indiana, 6'1 junior, number 11, Tion McCoy. From Roxbury, Massachusetts, 6'4 sophomore, number 14, Jesse Martin. From Sussex, Virginia, 6'9 senior, number 25, Tony Messenberg. From Greenbelt, Maryland, 6'10 sophomore, number 32, Jerrod Mustaf. From Temple Hills, Maryland, 6'8 sophomore, number 42, Walt Williams. And in his first year back at Maryland, head coach Gary Williams.
There you have our lineups, and Terry Gannon, there's an electric atmosphere in here, and we are going to tip it off and get underway in just a moment from College Park, Duke and Maryland. Stay tuned. Here are our officials today. That's Jerry Donahue in the center, flanked by Larry Limbaugh on the left and Stan Rote on the right. We are ready to play basketball in College Park. Massenberg and Abdelnabi will jump in and Jerry Donahue will toss it up. There you see the series record. Duke has a big, big lead. And it's Duke controlling the opening tip. That's Greg Kubek inside the Laettner. Bumped by Massenberg and fell down, and Christian Laettner may be hurt.
What a big play right off the bat. Laettner thought he got pushed down low in the post. So did Mike Krzyzewski. His feet got tangled. He went down. It looks like it's his knee. See if we can see it right here. Does he get pushed? Tough to tell. No, I don't think so.
Looks like he just twisted his knee when he caught the ball and just simply fell down.
Boy, what a big play. I mean, not just this game, but if they lose Laettner. The guy's been dynamite for Duke. Over 16 a game, almost 10 rebounds a game. It looks like he's walking off, but he's in a lot of pain. Here we have it again from the top angle. The pass down low, a little contact down low, but really nothing that would push him over. I mean, Massenberg had his hand on him, but I think he just got his legs tangled, Mike, and twisted his knee. There you see he's walking off. Looks a lot better right now.
Well, that's certainly a great sign, Terry, to see that he's walking like that with very little limp. Robert Bricky is into the Duke lineup to replace it. Maryland will have the basketball. We resume play.
Speaking of bad knees, Robert Bricky goes in for Christian Laettner. Of course, Bricky coming off that knee injury, out 8 games. We talked about it at the top of the show. Watch here. The first 5 minutes, I think, will be crucial. In the first game, Duke just dominated down low in the first half. He got such a big lead, they couldn't come back.
Massenberg, the senior, gets the first bucket of the game, the first score for Maryland. They draw the lead.
And you saw how they went right down to the block to Massenberg. Here's the 1-3-1 half-court trap. Duke had trouble against this. That's when Maryland made their run in the first game.
Abdelnabi in the paint, gives it inside to Kubek. Great head fakes inside. Kubek with his own rebound and follow. Nice toughness inside for Greg Kubek, who is one of those guys who's really come on when Robert Bricky got hurt.
He's been up and down. He'll have a good game, then he sort of disappear for a while. In the big games like this with a lot of emotion, he's been good, though.
Bobby Hurley did a great job of stripping the ball from Walt Williams, as Williams, much taller than Hurley, took it inside him.
Hey, is this crowd hopping or what? I mean, the students were outside by dawn this morning in the rain waiting to get in.
Basket will not count. Tony Massenberg took steps before he took the shot.
And I tell you what, Gary Williams will be sweating by the 15-minute mark. That's my prediction. He will have the coat off and be sweating by the 15-minute mark of the first half.
Kubek has the ball knocked out of bounds by Williams, and they're going to say that Walt Williams hit Greg Kubek on the iron. First personal foul on Williams, our first foul of the game.
Larry Lembo taking control right off the bat. In an emotional game like this, it's really important for the officials to do that. Here you have the play where Williams bounces into Kubek and knocks him over. Yeah, looks like uprights right there.
Duke trying to get organized on the inbounds play. 2-0, 2-2 our score. We're in the first minute of the basketball game here. Bobby Perlin to Kubek. McCoy with the rebound for Maryland, and here comes the Terrapins on offense. Mustaf.
Not enough rhythm that time. Didn't get set.
Bobby Hurley into the forecourt now.
Maryland back to the line.
Christian Laettner is waiting to come in. Apparently that knee injury not as serious as it might have first looked. Ball will belong to Maryland out of bounds. You see a shot of Abdelnaby, knocked it out. Foul's called on Abdelnaby, his first.
He's played well. He's had 14 straight double-figure games for Duke.
Jesse Martin with the basketball, and there is a whistle underneath. This time, I think Leighton's going to be called for the foul. Be the first foul on Leighton. Second foul on the Duke Blue Devils.
See, Mike Krzyzewski, we talked to him yesterday, and he really didn't mind the one-day practice. He only had a day to practice and come in here. He says sometimes that's good. Players don't get a chance to really think about how badly they played the night before or how badly they shot, shooting less than 35% against Virginia.
Mustaf drives in the lane, and he's fouled on the way through by Greg Kubek. First foul on Kubek, 13 for the Blue Devils.
If they can get the offense set and get the ball to a guy like Mustaf, he's 6'10", 244. Look at how mobile he is. I mean, that shouldn't be legal, a guy that big being able to drive to the basket like that. If they can drive today, that's one of the keys against Duke because they overplay so much. They overplay every passing angle, and it's tough to really run an offense. Today, Maryland's got to drive to the basket to be effective.
Well, we're tied at two. We're in the first 2 minutes. 18:02 left in the first half. Mustaf tries to break the tie. Well, can't do it. 75% free throw shooter on the season. Leading scorer on this Maryland team, averages 17 points a game.
He was only 6 for 15 against Duke the first time at Cameron. Tony Massenberg only 4 for 11, so that tells you a big story.
Mustaf scores his first point of the game, and Maryland has a one-point lead.
There's a trap once again. They'll trap on this side. Duke's got a split of his drive right there with Hurley.
Hurley tripped as he tried to split the double team there, Terry. Mustaf will be called for the personal foul, his first. Well, it's good to see that the injury to Christian Laettner wasn't serious. He watched him run up and down the court the last couple of times. Seems to have shaken it off pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, if they lose him against Maryland today with the big guys from Maryland, boy, it's awfully tough when you're on the road.
This is Greg Kubek. Works against Williams. Laettner, Hurley for three. Bobby Hurley with 3 points.
When they front the man down low, that time they really worked hard. Mustaf worked hard on fronting Ala Abdelnaby. If Duke swings the ball, they'll get that shot on the weak side.
Early 25 out of 67 coming into this season on three-pointers. Maryland will have the ball underneath their basket. Jesse Martin will play it in. Both teams kind of feeling each other out here in the early going. Walt Williams inside. At 6'8", he really likes to do that. Take those smaller guys guarding him inside, and he was successful that time.
Well, he likes to do it because he does it so well.
Exactly. Ala Abdelnaby can't find the handle. Walt Williams can. Here comes Maryland. Martin double team.
Good hands.
Henderson with the steal for Duke. Hurley open for a moment, now drives on the baseline. Hurley and Williams tie it up. A little bit of a size mismatch there, but a good job underneath by Bobby Hurley.
That's when you'd like to see the jump ball still in effect, to see one of those. See if Hurley, with all his competitiveness, could get up there and at least get a hand on the ball on the jump ball. Williams that time just swung him right around on the baseline.
Robert Bricky is back into the Duke lineup. Greg Kubek will take a rest. Walt Williams. Oh, Walt Williams off balance. Great shot from the free throw line. Williams with four. He's 2 for 2 in the game. The double team worked that time, Terry Gannon. Bobby Hurley couldn't get through, and the turnover gives the ball to the Terrapins.
Well, you learn it in CYO ball. The last thing you want to do is go across half court, then pick up your dribble in the trap. See, right there, he's got the sideline as another defender. The half court line was right behind him, the worst place you can be in a trap.
Duke three turnovers, Maryland two. Williams, our Mustaf, excuse me, down low this time. 3 points for Jerrod. And Maryland's largest lead at four.
Mike, the defensive intensity for Duke is not what it was in that first game and not what it is a lot of times. Maryland really able to drive to the basket early.
Maryland is on a 6-0 run, Terry. Foul that time was called on Jesse Martin. That is his first on the 6'4 sophomore from Roxbury, Massachusetts. 9-5, Maryland leads. Robert Bricky slams inside.
There you go. Forget chemistry. When he does those things, you'd like to have him back no matter what.
That's one of the great reasons you like to have Robert Bricky back in the lineup. What a super athlete he is. Martin loses the handle, and the ball goes out of bounds. That turnover will give the ball to the Duke Blue Devils. 15:49 left to play in the first half. Maryland leads Duke 9-7. Now a word from our good friends at Budweiser.
There's a great example of the Maryland offense. That's the key for them. 90 points a game when they win, only 68 when they lose. You see the field goal percentage, the difference there. And on the defense, not much of a difference. 73 to 77 and 40 to 46. They have offensive lapses. That's what kills them.
Full court pressure and a turnover gives the basketball to Maryland. Great play on defense by the Maryland Terrapins. They're playing well on both ends of the floor. Martin gets it inside. Abdelnaby with the rebound for Duke.
Like, what a rebound, too. There was no one going to take it away from him that time.
Hurley working against McCoy. And Teon's going to be called for the personal foul. First foul on Teon McCoy, the junior from Hammond, Indiana. Harry Williams.
He's got 26 seconds to start sweating and take off the jacket. My prediction is
your prediction doesn't work, right?
Oh, look at this.
And another turnover gives the ball to the Maryland Terrapins.
Another turnover, and Greg Kubek comes right off the bench for Mike Krzyzewski. Abdelnaby goes and sits down.
Duke has 5 turnovers in the game, Maryland 3. Maryland with a 9-7 lead. Williams against Hurley. Lob inside, good defense by Christian Layton.
Now that's a pass that's just not going to get there. When you start your offense out top, the top of the key, you've got to make the pass to the wing before you lob it down low, especially because Duke really helps well on the inside.
Tony Massenberg with 2. He's got 4 in the game. And Maryland's back up to a 4-point lead. Those 5 turnovers for Duke have come in only 10 possessions. Not good statistics. Henderson in the lane. Oh, great move inside by Henderson. Missed the shot. Kubek with the foul. Mustaf. Massenberg coming down strong with the rebound.
Mustaf grabbed the rim on that first shot. I think they missed one.
Massenberg. 6 points for Tony Massenberg, and he's got this crowd at Coalfield House in gear. He's also got his Maryland Terrapins out in front by 6, and there's another turnover. Walt Williams, and I believe he stepped on the sideline. Jerry Donahue right there to make the call.
Not much of a protest from Jerry Williams. It was right in front of him. You know, against that 1-3-1 trap, and Duke worked on it all day yesterday. He worked on it at great length yesterday in practice because the first game in Cameron, Duke actually turned the ball over 25 times. They won by 11, but the run that Maryland made was in the second half, and because of that 1-3-1 trap, they struggled against it today, too.
Laettner for 3.
He's so good. 6'10", 240. He's out there. Same thing with Mustaf. You got 2 guys who are such great athletes today at 6'10 on the court.
Good defense by Brian Davis, who's just coming to the game for Duke. And that's one of the reasons he's in there along with Billy McCaffrey. Another one of those hot freshmen for the Big Blue Devils. Davis.
There he goes.
Here goes Davis all the way. Oh. Davis. Boy, that'll light a fire under somebody in a hurry.
You think he meant that one?
Wow.
You knew what was going to happen from the half-court line. Brian Davis came into Duke as a 6'5 freshman. He's now up to 6'7. They say he may go to 6'9 or 6'10. We're talking about another David Robinson type story where a guy comes in at 6'4, 6'5 and ends up 6'10. What a leaper, too. They say he is that close. My fingers are, what, half an inch apart from being a Robert Bricky leaper.
Davis, only a sophomore from Bladensburg, Maryland. One of several players on this Duke team with Maryland connections. Williams works against Hurley, gets it into the forecourt.
Bricky had Jesse Martin in the man-to-man. Martin had a big game. He drives well to the hoop. That's why he plays well against Duke.
Laettner's good defense on Tony Massenberg.
Get out of the hole!
Almost a steal by Robert Bricky. Well, Duke has turned up the defensive pressure here a notch, Terry, and it seems to have made a difference in their play.
Yeah, but at Bricky that time, I think it was almost a steal because of that knee. I think if he was at full strength, he'd have had that thing and he would have gone down here and he'd done a 360 and broken a backboard and whatever. But the knee really sort of slows him up. I don't think he's quite at 100%.
As we saw in that dunk a few minutes ago, he can still get up there. Inside, Mustaf. Over Bricky. 5 points for Jerrod Mustaf. Maryland is shooting 70%, 7 out of 10. You can't do much better than that. This is Layton. Brian Davis. Billy McCaffrey, good shooter, just coming to the game a moment ago. Bobby Hurley will reset the Duke offense now. Davis to Bricky. Jesse Martin with the quick hands inside. Martin was able to knock it out off of Robert Bricky. Good play all around by Jesse Martin.
Yeah, good hustle by Bricky, too. On the defensive end, when Maryland is in there and Phil Henderson is not for Duke, they're able to really sag inside. As you see the points in the paint, Maryland with 11, I told you that was the key. But when they can sag and not have to cheat out on too many guys, when Henderson is out of there, they're more effective defensively.
Lewis just in the game. He's fouled on the way up. Cedric Lewis, the junior from Temple Hills, Maryland. There you see Christian Layton, guilty of the personal foul.
Good interior passing right down low. He had the angle on him. Went strong to the hoop and just a foul on Laettner. Laettner thought he went straight up in the air, but they'll call that 9 times out of 10.
Maybe a possible story later in this game, Terry. That's the second personal on Christian Laettner. And we have 12:52 left to play here in the first half.
Well, it just puts more pressure on Ala Abdel Nabi, and then the other guys, maybe a Bricky, Brian Davis, or a Thomas Hill who comes in half the play down low. It's very tough to match up with a 6'10 Mustaf, a Massenberg, who's 6'9, and a Cedric Lewis.
Lewis, a 6'9 junior, misses both free throws. He's only shooting 56% for the season. His strength is on the defensive end. He leads the team in block shots.
Going up.
Oh. What a play by Walt Williams to take the ball away from Billy McCaffrey. If it's Broadnax breaking down the court, and Broadnax cannot catch up with it. Broadnax, the junior from Forestville, Maryland, just into the game but could not catch up to the pass from Walt Williams.
And that's so tough when you're sitting on the bench because the coach will turn and yell at you. You're sitting right next to him. You didn't do anything, but he yells at you because the other guys can't hear him on the court.
Early shot won't go. McCaffrey to Abdel Nabi inside. Broadnax is going to be called for reaching into the hand. Be the first foul on Vince.
Well, he's been a good player for them. He's a surprise. He was a walk-on, and he's come on and played really well, especially defensively. He's your basic infantry man. He's going to go down in the trenches and really gut it out inside. 3 weeks ago in a hotel in Charlottesville, before the Virginia game, Jerry Williams came to him and gave him his scholarship. He earned it.
That'll fire you up in a hurry. McCaffrey fouled in the act of shooting. Foul's going to be caught on Walt Williams. Phil Henderson back in the Duke lineup. He'll give Bobby Hurley a rest. McCaffrey, the 6'3 freshman from Allentown, Pennsylvania, an 81% free throw shooter, has really helped out this Duke team off the bench. He's been able to provide a lot of offense in some key games when they really needed it.
Kid's got the guts of a burglar. He comes in, he's a freshman just like Hurley, and I think he's gotten better since the beginning of the year. He's played against a tough competition and really progressed as a player. That's unusual right there.
Well, as you saw just a moment ago, he shoots over 80% on his free throws, and a rare miss for Billy McCaffrey.
He's got some people here from Allentown, as do a lot of the players. This is as close as Duke gets to the New Jersey, New York area, and they've got some players from that area of the country. A lot of fans in the stands from Duke.
And Billy McCaffrey missed both of them. You won't see that too often on the road or at home.
Here's the tough defense. That's what I'm talking about. In your shirt, and everybody denies the first pass away. One pass away, they'll deny it. You got a hand on it.
Massenberg did a good job of getting by Abdelnaby, but Abdelnaby comes down with the missed shot. Here comes Duke for the chance to cut into Maryland's three-point lead.
See, now they can't sag. You've got Henderson, as Ricky throws one up, Henderson and McCaffrey in the game. You can't sag off of both of those guys.
Williams for three. Walt Williams lights it up here.
He had to put a stamp on that one to get it home. That was from way out.
He's got 6 points. McCaffrey working against McCoy. Takes it all the way down. Can't find anybody to throw it to. And Maryland comes up with it. All McCaffrey saw when he turned around were white shirts. White shirts on the other end. Can't hit it. Davis down with the rebound, and he's fouled, a frustration foul on the part of Jerrod Mustaf. I think Mustaf was so upset that he didn't make that shot down there, Terry, that he created what was not a very smart foul on Brian Davis.
Especially being the second foul. I thought he had a foul on his move to the hoop, to be honest with you, and then got it back, and you're right, it was just out of frustration.
11:15 left to play here in the first half. Maryland leading Duke by a score of 18-12. Looked like a moment like we're going to have a timeout, but Jerry Donahue has gone over to confer at the official table. I think he's going to call the players back out there. And now
I'm not sure. What's
here
the
come
problem?
The Duke players back out, on the floor. So are the cheerleaders. Somebody's going to have to leave.
I got a feeling it might be the cheerleaders.
The Maryland cheerleaders in the middle of their routine, and the Duke Blue Devils out there ready to play some basketball.
That's like the NBA. We had a 20-second timeout there. Are we shooting the free throw? Yeah, they're in the bonus, so that was the reason. You always shoot the free throw before. You don't ever have a TV timeout take place right before the free throw occurred. So Davis got fouled down at the other end, and they'll walk down here and shoot the free throw at this end before the TV timeout.
Duke trails this game by 6 points, which is fortunate when you look at the shooting stats, Terry. Duke's 5 out of 13 for 38%. Maryland 8 out of 13, 62%.
Duke shot well.
Trying to cut it down.
All year long, Mike, Duke has shot well. They're over 50% as a ball club. But against Virginia, they sagged. Virginia did and forced the outside shot, and they struggled.
Here comes Maryland trying to increase that lead. The largest of the game now at 6. Mustaf off the glass.
See, when Walt Williams can back his way in and get to the free throw line, he has an advantage over Hurley because he's 6'8". He can make any pass he wants. It makes it a lot easier.
Maryland is on a 7-0 run.
Nice pass.
Abdelnaby up strong. Follows it strong and scores. Well, Abdelnaby stayed with the shot.
The second time in a week that Gary Williams and the Maryland crowd have wanted goaltending. They lost the game the other night when they wanted it at the end against Clemson.
Lob inside. Great play to Walt Williams.
See, they may have to make a switch. Hurley's on Williams. The height advantage for Williams is 6'8 to 6 feet.
Walt Williams is 4 for 4. He's got 9 points in the first half. Hurley. Ball's turned over to Tony Massenberg. Here comes Maryland. Martin breaking the Mustaf. Mustaf is fouled by Brian Davis. Right now, Maryland is on a big run, and this home crowd here at Cole Field House is really into it.
really playing well. Look at the lob right here. See, Hurley is trying to guard him. There's absolutely no way he's going to stop Walt Williams from doing that. He's got to get weak side help. Somebody has to talk and pick up Williams as he goes to the bucket, or else they've got to make a switch defensively.
And give some credit, too, on that play, Terry, to Jesse Martin, who has really fit in well with his team and has become such an integral part of this Maryland basketball team.
Well, as you look at Mustaf missing the first free throw, you're right. Jesse Martin was a center in high school. He came here, he played point guard, and at the beginning of the year this year, he was at the point guard position, plays much better inside.
Well, as you saw, neither team doing well at all from the foul line. Mustaf misses them both, but look at this. Maryland gets a rebound, Tony Massenberg. Great. Massenberg's got eight.
He's hard work down low on the free throw. Here you go, right over half court. Nice pass by Hurley to get out of that trap.
Henderson driving for Duke. Jesse Martin strong. Thomas Hill takes it away and scores. Hill, the freshman from Texas, gets his first bucket of the game, and it's the first Duke bucket in quite a while. The Maryland lead is eight. 9.5 to play in the first half.
Walt Williams out of the game. Hurley matches up a lot better with Keon McCoy.
Massenberg over Abdelnaby. Tony Massenberg. 10 points now for Tony Massenberg. And that's what the Maryland lead is, 10.
No way you can let Massenberg catch the ball down low in the paint. He catches it on the block and has a run down the other end.
Leitner's got it inside from Hurley. Christian Leitner with two.
Ditto for Leitner. If one of those guys, a Mustaf, a Massenberg, a Laettner, and an Abdelnaby catch the ball down low on the block, there is absolutely no way he can do anything but foul him or he's going to score.
Seeing some of the best big men in the Atlantic Coast Conference playing in this game today.
Yeah, you really are. You've got to front those guys down low, play in front of them, and just get weak side help.
5 second call. Good defense by Christian Laettner and Duke. Jerry Donahue was right on it. Gary Williams says he might have missed. 8:37 left to play in the first half. Maryland leads Duke 26-18.
The way Duke overplays every pass, especially the pass on the exterior out there, the thing that's open is for the big people to come up close to the basketball. Massenberg does a great job that time, and once he catches it down low, forget it, it's in the hoop. And you look at Tony Massenberg and all he's been through here. Take a look at this, the growth chart. As a senior, 16.7, all the way down, 2.9 as a freshman. Sometimes you just can't tell when you've got a gemstone in the making.
He's certainly the leader on this team, Christian Laettner, who's one of the tough big men to do. Can't get it to go down, and here comes Maryland again. Teon McCoy. Bobby Hurley fought him inside, tied him up. Arrow is pointing to Duke. Hurley again dribbles by the double team. Henderson, top of the key. Phil Henderson.
First time he's really been able to get set and get an outside jump shot. They're really going to shade to him. They sag and cheat. Sag and cheat to Henderson.
Thomas Hill, who is known for his quick hands and good defensive play, got a hand in there and knocked it out of bounds.
It's fun to watch that kid play. You know, he's one of those guys who's always smiling after he makes a good play. Nice back door.
Teon McCoy did a great job, as you said, running the back door, scoring for Maryland. Leads back up to eight now, 28-20. Henderson against Broad next. Boy, that's quite a matchup. Inside Abdelnaby loses it. Ball goes out. It will belong to Duke. Massenberg, one of those who tried to save it. 7:43 to play, first half. Maryland has an 8-point lead. Right now, a good word from our friends at Budweiser. Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon back with you at Cole Fieldhouse in College Park. Yes, there are some happy, happy fans here for the University of Maryland Terrapins. It turns out in front of Duke by 8 points. During halftime, we'll have the Mazda game summary. A look at first period action, which so far has been pretty much in favor of the Terps in the white shirts. Thomas Hill for three. Hill with 5 points in the game. And if he can offer some offense to this crew,
yeah,
he'd really be a big plus because he's such a good defensive player.
He's in there for his defense. His quickest. He gets his hands on the ball. A good athlete. If he can hit a few shots on the offensive end, that's icing on the cake.
Evers Burns just into the game from Maryland. Misses a shot. Here comes Duke.
Duke's got to find a way to get the ball down low. Christian Laettner had a bucket down low. See, they're just struggling getting the ball in there. And they don't shoot well when they don't get in a position to get good shots. It's not that they're not hitting their outside shots. They're just struggling getting good shots.
We see some tough defense play today. Evers Burns on the other end from Maryland with that good defensive steal. This is Massenberg. One of his rare misses today. Massenberg's 5 out of 7 on the afternoon.
Yeah, look on his face like, how did I shoot that one off the backboard?
Good defense by Vince Broadnax. Phil Henderson lost control for a moment. You see him arguing with Jerry Donahue, and we'll take a look at it again.
They're just not real sharp today, just like the other night against Virginia. I think they've come out with some intensity, but I don't think they're sharp. You know, when you're on the road and you go from playing a late night game to a game on Saturday when you're away from home, it's awfully tough. If they were at home, they would be in an environment which they're used to, and the crowd could get them into the game.
Maryland is still shooting 70%. It may go down with that miss. Foul underneath.
We called on Brian Davis.
It'll be his second. Shooting has been a big story in this game, Terry, as Duke is still below 50%, Maryland around 70%. That's the difference in the game.
Backdoor, oh, they just missed him, man. Williams going backdoor once again on Hurley. Now they post him up. Really trying to take advantage of that height disadvantage that Hurley has.
Martin. Look at the back door from Mustaf. Now Martin will take the shot of a Bricky. Jesse Martin.
He's been playing well against everyone, Mike, but he plays especially well against Duke because he loves to drive to the basket and hang around down low.
Good pass from Hurley to Abdelnaby, the follow by Laettner.
You can do that against the trap, against that 1-3-1 trap. One of the things you want to do is look up the court and behind. Offense.
Trying, as we have said, to take Bobby Hurley down low, and that time Hurley stood his ground, took the charge.
Hurley's such a smart defensive player. He uses his feet, he beats him to the baseline. There's no doubt about that. You saw the arm going out. Williams just pushed him off. You see the quick feet by Hurley right here. Yeah, he just put the shoulder right into him. And that's one place where he can stay with him. I mean, defensively, he's got the quickness to stay with him, but if Williams takes him down low for a lob or to post him up, it's tough. Get there.
Laettner, Brian Davis. Mike Anderson just into the game for Maryland. Has it taken away by Bobby Hurley. Hurley's going to be called for the foul. Anderson, the senior from Maryland, Capitol Heights, Maryland, just came into the game. Picks up a foul from Bobby Hurley.
It's one of those where Hurley grabbed the ball afterwards. If it was a playground, say, that's my ball, I'm going home. You call a foul like that, I'm going home and taking my ball with me.
Anderson will be going to the line for 2 shots. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports. And the use of this broadcast without the express permission of Raycom and JP Sports is prohibited. Anderson, a 71% free throw shooter, hits his first.
How about this kid, Anderson? He went to DeMatha. He was in the backcourt with assistant coach from Maryland, Mike Galen. He's on the football team. December 11th was his first practice. They brought him on to play the next day against Coppin State. He's really provided a lot of emotion for these guys. Jerry Williams talked about some of the older guys, like Massenberg, and maybe thought it was too cool to raise a fist and yell and scream, and Anderson came out and really provided that.
Other than emotion, he's also provided some quickness, especially on the defensive end of the floor for Maryland. 32-25. Our score, Maryland leads, and Anderson is going to be called for the block that time. Bobby Hurley's got a little quickness, too.
Yeah, I'd say so. Everybody's got the haircuts these days. The barbers must love the ACC. You know, everybody's got the Ollie North thing. Bobby Hurley, McCaffrey's got one. That guy doesn't have one. I don't think we'll see him have one, although we know Terry Holland had one after the win the other night.
I was going to say, that's the haircut I want to see. Terry Holland's flat top. So many of you saw it in an earlier game today.
I don't know what happened. Hurley ended up about 3 feet to the left. up the free throw line that time. He sort of faded, almost like he got fouled on his free throw. Watch him on this one, see if he goes straight up and down. He's got a little bit of bounce in his free throw.
That's faded away. Abdelnaby had a hand on it, but Maryland comes down with Brodnack in the lane. Brian Davis strong for the rebound for Duke. Here come the Blue Devils. Abdelnaby. Laettner. And Mustaf gets it amongst a bunch of trees for Maryland. Evers Burns, little strong.
Look at the scrambles out here. On the board, now on the floor. Here goes Davis.
That's the second one of those we've seen today from Brian Davis.
And I'll tell you something, Bricky and Davis were nose to nose after that. Davis is out here, I mean, he's playing with heart. I think this crowd's got him fired up. He thinks he's in Cameron Indoor. I mean, he just rose and rose. He got called for the offensive foul, but it's a play like that, when they count the basket, that can get a team fired up on the road.
That basket made this a pretty tight basketball game again. The margin now only 4, 32-28. 4:45 to play first half. And Anderson will try to redeem himself at the free throw line.
You know, and Anderson goes to the line, but I'll guarantee you tomorrow when they watch the film, he won't want to watch that. You know, there's nothing more embarrassing than to get punched on, as they call it. He's underneath. He took the charge, but when Davis rose up above, tomorrow the guys will be all over him. Guarantee it.
Anderson's turned into a pretty good free throw shooter. He's got three from the line today. He's used to taking hits, though, of being a tailback on the football team. Knows how to take that stuff inside for the big guys.
Well, that's why he's on the team. I mean, to take a charge like that, give up your body. I mean, Davis comes flying at you. Now, how many guys would stand there and let him just run right into him, or over him, as it were?
Anderson with four off on the line. As you saw a moment ago, his best game has been against Duke. He had 8 points last time these two played. Bricky
got hit.
Broadnax has it for Maryland. Anderson looks to his coach for the play and now runs the offense for the Terps.
Spread the court, they'll play the triangles on both sides.
Good job, the Anderson ball avoiding the 5 second call. Nice pass to Brodnack. Offensive foul. Good job, Christian Laettner. Now remember, Laettner has two fouls. So he was taking a chance at picking up number three, but it was a pretty smart defensive play.
That is a chance to take. Watch Mustaf drive to the bucket, though. In between the traps, the dish to the right. The guy's 6'10". And that's a chance that he took. But it's a good chance to take, to draw a charge like that. That's a good defensive play.
Abdelnaby scores. Give the assist, though, to Robert Bricky. That was a great pass inside.
They draw within four. And remember, the thing that kills Maryland is the offensive drop against Clemson and Georgia Tech the last two games. They went 8 minutes straight without scoring a bucket.
Massenberg with a Laettner. Mustaf has it. Jerrod Mustaf has been silent for the last 6 or 7 minutes. He makes his presence felt there for Maryland.
See down here if Laettner gets a shot from the outside. Oh, nice cut by Bricky.
Fouled on the way up by Tony Massenberg. Only the first foul on Massenberg. Bricky will go to the line.
Beautiful cut by Robert Bricky. On the offensive end of the court down here for Duke. Laettner had a shot a couple times. As Maryland really cheats down low on Abdelnaby. If they swing the ball to the opposite side, they can get a shot. They had it earlier with Hurley. They can do it with Laettner, although he's out of the ball game right now. Whoever's over here, Kubek, a good shooter from the wing. See if they can swing the ball next time down and get him a shot.
Bricky hits, as you saw a moment ago, just over 70% of his free throws. Got 3 points here in this ball game. Since he came back in the game against Notre Dame, Terry, he's scoring well below his 13.2 per game average. But as Coach K said in the pregame today, it may take him a couple more weeks before we see the Robert Bricky of old.
Hey, it's timing. It's not football. We just go out and hit each other. This is basketball. Finesse.
3:32 to play in the first half. Maryland leads Duke by 4 points. Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon back with you. Maryland leads Duke as we come down the final 3.5 minutes of this first half. The Terps 10-1 when shooting over 50% from the field, and they're doing that today, Terry.
Shooting great from the outside. 15 of 26, 13 of 26. Duke has picked it up a little bit, too. They're shooting right around, that is right at 50%, as a matter of fact. They were way down there at about 33% earlier. That's pretty good math. That was a history maker.
Maryland, a four-point lead in the basketball. Martin, short. Ball goes out off of Tony Massenberg. It belongs to Duke.
You know, another statistic, and I don't live by statistics, but Duke is 17-0 when they're up at halftime, only 1-4 when they're down.
Henderson, a great double pump, and then the shot. Phil Henderson with four.
Big 3 minutes right here. Coaches always point to the last three and the first three of the second half. The last three of that first half.
Hurley calls for the block on Mike Anderson. Second foul on Bobby Hurley.
Nice going foul. You don't want to pick up too many of those.
This is as close, Terry, as Duke has been since the beginning of this basketball game. Anderson, who's been deadly from the free throw line, will try to get a little more breathing room on that scoring margin.
Wouldn't be surprised to see Walt Williams back in there in a bit. Anderson and Keon McCoy at the guard. With Williams in there, they really have an advantage over Hurley when they take him down low.
Mike Anderson is 5 of 5 from the free throw line, trying to go 6 and 6. The rest of the Maryland team, 1 out of 6. Make that 5 of 6. But needless to say, he has been deadly from the free throw line. Here's Bricky. Great block by Mustaf. Jesse Martin. Kubek with good defense to come up with the ball for the Duke Blue Devils.
Off balance. Tough shot to hit when you're on the run, a little bit off balance. Here comes Maryland, a windshield wiper game this last minute.
Jerrod Mustaf. The M&M boys, as you call them, Terry, have been dangerous inside. Mustaf and Massenberg.
See if Duke can really try to set up that half-court offense right now. Get something down low. Get the ball to Abdel Nabi. Swing it to get it inside.
Phil Henderson misses a three. Mustaf with the rebound. Mustaf in the first half, 5 out of 7 from the field, 11 points.
We said those two struggled. Massenberg and Mustaf in that first game. The reason why Duke got an 18-point lead and hung out.
The other end of Massenberg.
You know, that's why he's so tough. I mean, you go down low, he's tough down there, he's too strong for you, and he can hit the top of the key jump shot. Where do you guard him? Where do you cheat to?
Hoplin on the inside.
There you go. Swung the ball nicely, moved it side to side. When you move the ball side to side, it's really tough for the defense to get back on the blocks when the ball goes to this side over here. Nice pass inside.
I think Abdelnabi really seems to have worked on. He's got a little turnaround hook shot. Anderson finds Martin. Martin fights through heavy traffic, takes it inside. Tricky will be called for the foul. Martin will go to the line. May have noticed this, Mike Anderson has done a pretty good job of running this team for the last 5 or 6 minutes. So good that Walt Williams has had a lot of time on the bench.
He goes out of the lineup right now. He has, though. One of the things, you know, defensively, he's so quick, but offensively, you worry about his decision-making because he, you know, he hasn't played but since December 11th. So you wonder about that as you see Kubek going out with two. Of course, Laettner has two as well. And this guy's really done a nice job. Four guys have been in double figures for most of the year. Walt Williams, Tony Massenberg, Jesse Martin, Jerrod Mustaf. Led in the well.
Martin with a great future ahead of him here at the University of Maryland. Major in family studies. As he right now wants to go to graduate school. When he graduates. That's a couple of years and a lot of basketball down the road. Two free throws and it's 43-36.
Good no call. Two guys, one from Maryland, one from Duke, stepped in the lane before he even let that one go. It's like a hook shot on the team.
Joe Cook into the game now for Duke. Oh, he has a block by Massenberg. And that's Everett Burns with the rebound.
What a block by Massenberg. He's got 27. That's his 28th on the year. Keep going. Deion McCoy started to go back door, just keep going to the hoop. Nice idea, but you got to follow through.
Everett Burns made that pass, a freshman from Baltimore. We've got to look at our two coaches, Krzyzewski and Williams. Both of them done a fine job this year. Joe Cook beats the pressure from Deion McCoy, double team. Thomas Hill. Maybe a goaltending call. Indeed it is, says Jerry Donahue.
Yeah, ball was up there. They called the goaltending. Jerry Williams upset. He thought that he had one earlier in the game that wasn't called. Of course, when you lose a game on one of those that you think should be called, too, like the other night against Clemson, but it sticks in the cross.
Final 25 seconds of the first half. Hill with 7 points for Duke. He's 3 for 3. Been a big force here in the first half.
Shot clock is off. They'll try to handle the ball here in this spread offense, and then maybe Jesse Martin will drive the basket, or Keon McCoy looks for the little jump shot or the dish.
McCoy behind his back, throws it up.
Nah.
Massenberg threw it up off balance at the buzzer. It was a little strong, but the crowd here at Coalfield House on its feet. They're Maryland Terrapins. Our surprising fourth-ranked Duke at the half. Our score is 43-38. We're back in College Park, Cole Field House, 43-38. Maryland out on top of fourth-ranked Duke. Terry, I might say that this might be some of a surprise, but Duke coming off the loss on Thursday night, they still don't seem to be quite in sync, and Maryland, on the other hand, is playing an excellent, excellent basketball game.
Maryland did come out playing well right off the bat. I mean, they got the big crowd, everybody outside camping out for this game, and it's something that they haven't really had in a while. This year is the first year they've had that in a while. Just pumps you up. Gary Williams out here before the game, getting ready with the crowd, and it carried over to the game. I think they've been very active defensively. That 1-3-1 half-court trap has been effective. Done a nice job down low, sort of keeping the Duke guys away from the board. Ala Abdelnaby, Christian Laettner really didn't dominate inside the way they did back at Duke. So that intensity is there. I think Duke, they might have struggled a little bit because they're tired. Second half, the first 3 or 4 minutes, though, will tell for Duke whether they've got it back and they're bouncing back.
That's my next question to you, Terry. Do you think Duke is a tired basketball team? They did play the 9 o'clock game in Charlottesville on Thursday, but Charlottesville's not that long a trip to College Park.
Yeah, but it's awfully tough. When you're on the road, and especially when you get beat, the game ended about 11:30 on Thursday night. It's a tough loss. You have to come back the next day. You don't have much time to prepare, and you're not at home. Sometimes when you're at home, the crowd gets you up when you start the ball game. You don't have that on the road. In fact, the crowd's against you.
All right, it's time now for the Mazda game summary, brought to you by Mazda Cars and Trucks. It just feels right. You talked about the M&M guys for Maryland, and both of them played well.
Yeah, especially the 1M, Massenberg. Watch him right here. When you get the ball down low, if Tony Massenberg gets the ball, there's nothing Abdelnaby can do but to just stand there and put his hand up. He's so good, so strong down low in the paint, and he's been really effective today. Now watch on the defensive end. This isn't supposed to happen against Abdelnaby. You talked about that little jump hook. Massenberg, what timing. He goes up, blocks the shot, then stays in there tough and creates the bad shot by Abdelnaby. Defensively, I mean, that's just a great possession by Maryland and by Massenberg. That's what they've done. They've handled Duke down low.
He's got 12 points in the first half. He's been a big difference. We talked about Duke and their chemistry. Robert Bricky coming back into the lineup. That doesn't seem to me to be the only problem with Duke in the first half, the chemistry, although it might have been a little bit of a problem.
Well, it's tough to tell, I really think, because what happens is that your substituting pattern, first of all, is thrown off, although Mike Krzyzewski really doesn't have a solid one. He sort of goes game by game. But I think what happens is you don't know how to react to Robert Bricky. You've got to get used to playing with him once again. And it's not the same Robert Bricky. He's not as, doesn't have the speed that he used to have, doesn't jump quite as well. And it's just hustle that he's doing it on. So you have to adjust to all those things. It just takes a while to do that.
All right. Well, Duke Blue Devils had some problems scoring early in this first half. Then later in the first half, they started shooting a lot better and running their offense a whole lot better, Terry.
That's how they made their run, I think. Here you see Hurley driving against that 1-3-1 trap, which you can do when you split the trap. Guys are going to be open down low. Good pump fake by Ala Abdelnaby. He followed it up. That's what they need to do. They need a guard like Henderson or Hurley to split that trap. And if they do and look past that 1-3-1 trap down low, they've got guys open.
Right, and it's plays like that is the reason that Duke was able to cut that lead from 10 points down to five, which is where we stand at halftime right now. What has Duke got to do, you think, in the second half to jump out and get over the hurdle a little bit?
First of all, the emotion. We talked about that before the game. Really important. The first 3 minutes to come out and make a run. Secondly, I think they need to be more patient offensively. Move the ball. The couple times that they moved the ball, swung it from side to side, they got someone open down low, or they got the weak side jump shot. Those two things, I think, right off the bat they have to do to get back in the game. It's only a five-point game. They're not out of it, but right off the bat, set the tempo.
If the M&M boys, though, continue to play well, it could be another great day for Maryland. Our score at halftime is 43-38. We'll be back in a moment, but first, these messages from the Atlantic Coast Conference.
From the D.C. Beltway through Tobacco Road to the hub of the South, winter means basketball in the Atlantic Coast Conference. The ACC has dominated NCAA play in the 80s with the most wins, most appearances, and the highest winning percentage of any conference. It's basketball at its best. The Atlantic Coast Conference.
In basketball, when you make the front end of the one-on-one, you get a second shot. In life, if you can't read, you're out of the game. Make sure you're in the starting lineup, stay in school, use your public library, and read.
College Park, Maryland, Cole Field House, the site of our game between Maryland and Duke. Maryland on top at halftime, 43-38. We'll be back with more halftime activities from College Park in just a moment. We're back in College Park. Mike Hogwood along with Terry Gannon. Maryland leads Duke at halftime, 43-38. Duke, of course, trying to rebound after that tough loss on Thursday night at Virginia. Maryland trying to come back after a heartbreaker Wednesday night at Clemson. I think we've got an exciting second half of basketball ahead of us. Atlantic Coast Conference basketball on Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports will continue after these messages from your local ACC stations.
Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports exclusive coverage of ACC basketball is brought to you by Mazda, Holly Farms, Lowe's, Gillette, and by Ford.
Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon back with you. Stay tuned, fans, for the Holly Farms Players of the Game Award brought to you by Holly Farms, America's number one brand of fresh chicken. Holly Farms will contribute $1,000 to the Atlantic Coast Conference to be distributed among the member institutions under a conference-approved plan. That's the Holly Farms Players of the Game to be awarded near the conclusion of our broadcast. Now it's time for our halftime stats brought to you by U.S. Air.
You see, Duke shooting only 44%. They usually shoot 50% on the average. Maryland shooting the lights out at 56, almost 57%. The three-point shots, Duke had a few more. Free throws, look at that, only 43% for Duke. They're a much better free throw shooting team than that. The rebounding advantage goes to Maryland. That'll be a key, the people down low. And 14 turnovers in the first half by Duke against that 1-3-1 trap. One of the reasons that they're down right now.
Well, the largest lead for Maryland in the first half was 10. The score at halftime, 43-38. The difference now, 5. Well, interesting note, Terry, for Duke, from the field, their starters, 10 of 27, 37%. The bench, 6 of 9, 67%. As you get a look at Mike Krzyzewski, obviously a look of concern on his face, but he's got to be happy with the way the guys on the bench are playing.
Well, when you get a guy like Brian Davis, all he does is dunk. So it's kind of hard to miss those off the bench. He's done that today, had two big ones.
Thomas Hill was 3-for-3 as well. Maryland with the ball to start the second half of play. Tony Massenberg, Jesse Martin. Once against Robert Bricky, down low to Walt Williams. Bobby Hurley is going to be called for the personal foul on Walt Williams. Hurley seems to be having a little trouble with Walt Williams, and it may be the size or whatever it is. He seems to be having a little problem.
Sure, down low, you've got Walt Williams, who's 6'8". I mean, any six-foot guard would have trouble with him. And Williams sat out much of that, the latter part of the first half, and that's when Duke started to make their run, because they can take him and go down low defensively and really put Hurley at a disadvantage. When you have guys like Keon McCoy and Mike Anderson in there, he can guard those guys both down low and outside.
Hurley has three personal fouls, and again, we're in the opening minute of the second half. Nice pass inside to Massenberg, to Mustaf. Great teamwork on the part of the Maryland Terrapins.
Yeah, they really braved that weakness on the weak side, because as Duke overplays the inside pass to Massenberg, which they have to, the guy from the weak side has to come over, and that leaves Mustaf open.
Ryan Davis, who's starting the second half, along with Robert Brickey, Christian Laettner, a la Abdenabi with the ball, to Laettner in the paint.
They need him in there. He's such a key for them, both from the outside and the inside. As we said, Ala can drop people down low and really create weaknesses in the defense and open up the shots for Laettner.
Mustaf. Davis down with the rebound. That time down, Terry, they had Davis guarding Williams. Here's a long pass to Abdelnaby. He's going to be fouled by Jesse Martin. Early it switched off to McCoy, and Davis was guarding Williams. We'll have to see how that works.
Well, there's nothing that really makes a coach madder than when his big people get beat down the court. Abdelnaby just beat everyone right down the court that time. And defensively, as a coach, that's just sheer hustle and heart. I mean, there's no X and O involved in that.
Ala Abdelnaby hits his first free throw. He's got 7 points. Only 3 for 8 from the field today. And he is the leading field goal percentage shooter on this team at 62% on the season.
See if Duke right off the bat here really tries to put the pressure out. Just turn up the heat on Maryland, try to create some turnovers that first 3 minutes.
Martin's shot is blocked by Robert Brickey. But Brickey's going to be called for the personal foul.
Again, Robert Brickey just maybe a half step slower than he was. It'll just take him some time. He's laughing about it. He doesn't think so. He thought he had it all cleanly.
Duke definitely with a quick team in there now. With Davis and Brickey. Along with Laettner, Abdelnaby, and Bobby Hurley. Jesse Martin's first point of the second half. He's got 5 on the game. Terry, as you mentioned earlier, he's been a real plus to this team, scoring in double figures on the season, averaging 11.1 points per contest.
They've taken the crowd out in the second half. Crowd really hasn't been loud so far.
Laettner on the drive. Brickey goes up. And we'll have another foul inside on Maryland. Robert Brickey will go to the line. Tony Massenberg, I believe.
Those two guys, Brickey and Davis, they'd have to drive you crazy when you're down there trying to rebound, because they jump so well and they're so quick going to the basket. They slash to the basket with the ball and without the ball. And if you're 6'10", 6'9", like a Mustaf or a Massenberg, you're looking around trying to find those guys. They're so quick and they jump so quickly, it's hard to do.
Brickey trying to cut his 5-point lead down a little bit. Terry, I'll tell you, when you talk about Maryland and the crowd, you mentioned they were here at dawn this morning. There's a different atmosphere on this campus this year. Look at this statistic of how many more fans are here this year than were here last year. Yeah, really a neat thing to see.
They're so supportive. We were at practice yesterday, and the entire swim team came out in their little Speedos and little shower caps that they wear and did a big cheer for the team out here. And Gary Williams and the players turned to them and thanked them. That's the kind of support you love to have.
Abdelnaby down with the rebound after the long Williams miss. Duke a chance to cut further into this Maryland lead. Crowd called Abdelnaby walk. He missed the shot, and here's Maryland.
Oh, should have been ready. Tough pass to handle, but Deion McCoy, really a great idea. He had the shake and bake on Hurley and sort of shook him off, and then bam, the drop. Watch right here. Shake and bake right here. You go back, and the drop off. Tough to handle, but he's got to be ready for that pass. A good idea.
Well, if anybody doubted the jumping ability of Robert Brickey, we certainly saw it on that play, Terry. But he went a little too high, called for goaltending on the shot by Tony Massenberg.
I'd like to do that just once. Be able to play like Brickey once. Just jump like him one time. That's all I want.
Get up there, you get scared about coming down. Maryland leads it by 6 now. Laettner's open. Walt Williams down with a rebound for Maryland.
Half a second late. He had him open right away. And what happens sometimes as a point guard, you don't want to turn your head. You don't want to shield yourself and cut off one half of the court. Williams did that. He looked to the right that time, had McCoy open right away, and was just half a second late getting him the basketball.
And you talked about quick teams, Terry. Abdullahi has just gone out. Thomas Hill in to replace him. So you have Hill, Davis, and Brittany all on the floor at the same time for Duke. Martin misses. Walt Williams with a strong follow inside.
That's where they may get hurt. They put in the quick lineup, but you really get hurt down low with the size.
Thomas Hill, 4 for 4 today. He's got 9 points.
That's why we're paid to analyze. You can't figure this stuff out. You know, we talk about all the stars, Laettner, Allah, Abdelnaby, and all those guys, and then he comes off the bench and hits 4.
Williams, nice pass inside to Tony Massenberg. Ball hung on the rim for a moment, but as you hear from the crowd and saw, it went down, and Massenberg's got 14. Laettner.
That's a no-no. If you sag in the middle, you can't sag off of that guy. He's a guy that you cheat to.
Both teams trading baskets now. 53-47 our score. Williams, 5 out of 6 from the field today, 11 points. Fouls going to be called on the Duke Blue Devils. Give this man some credit, too. Gary Williams did a great job of getting his team prepared today to play Duke.
Well, they have all the outside distractions, and I think it may bother him more than the kids because he had to stand there 2 days ago for 2 hours and answer questions from the press. I mean, nobody wants to go through that, so there is a bit of a distraction. But for the kids, and he talked about this, that's their release on the basketball court. They can get away from all that out here.
Mustaf inside, and that little turnaround jump hook is really tough to stop. Mustaf's got 15 points today.
Here he's got the 2-3. Good zag in the middle. Here he goes.
Jesse Martin to Williams. Maryland has just equaled their largest lead of the game. It is back up to 10 on that bucket by Walt Williams, 57-47.
Now here as a coach is where you make a decision. Do you call a timeout or not? Mike Krzyzewski says no. We've been in enough tough games on the road. My ball club knows what to do.
Keon McCoy is going to be called for bumping into Bobby Hurley. Left to play in this basketball game. They're rocking at Cole Fieldhouse. The Terrapins lead it by 10. Now a word from our good friends at Budweiser.
Terps trying to make everybody happy. First of all, they try to make the crowd happy, and they get it done. Walt Williams on the fast break gets it back for Martin. Goes up, twists, turns. I'll give him a 9.8. Now this one, though, this makes their coach happy, Gary Williams. Getting the ball down low in the paint. Mustaf and Massenberg have been fantastic. They've got 33 points in the paint.
As you see the difference in the paint, and that's a large reason why the difference on the scoreboard is 10 points at 57-47. Duke will try to cut into that lead right now. Phil Henderson with the ball. He's back into the game. Did not start the second half for Duke Blue Devils. Laettner rattles it in.
I'll tell you something, too. On those rims, when you have the old breakaways, they're like sewers. That thing hit the front of the rim, the back of the rim, the side, the other side, and went in.
Sometime we have a half hour, he'll be out of this sewer.
Yeah, it all runs down into the sewer. You know.
Oh, I hear you. Massenberg for Maryland. Tony Massenberg has 18 points, Terry.
Yeah, I mean,
what a game.
Again, if you allow him to catch the ball, forget it. Run down the other end.
Really
battle down low, too, with Laettner and Massenberg. Watch them battle right here for position. They're fronting him right here with Massenberg. They get weak side help. Tough shot.
Davis misses. Laettner had it knocked away. Mustaf with it now. Jerrod stops.
Oh.
Oh, what a follow by Massenberg, but it didn't go. Davis on the other end to Laettner.
4-point swing.
He had the dunk, hit it off the heel, good outlet pass off the heel of that basket for Duke.
It really turned into a run and shoot basketball game, fast pace.
Watch Williams down low against Henderson. There's no way Henderson can guard him if they get on the ball.
Hill fell off of Martin. Martin had a free shot at the bucket but missed it. Hill's first miss of the game. Davis followed. Massenberg finally corrals the iron for Maryland.
His presence was felt.
Massenberg. Hill fights for the rebound. He's got it. He's going to be a whistle. And a foul called on Maryland. Jerry, I want to tell you, though, this Maryland team is playing with a lot of confidence here today.
Yeah, much different than earlier in the year. Remember when they played Connecticut and turned the ball over so much? Today, they're playing smart basketball, handling the ball well. And Duke, both teams right now, neither coach can be upset with the intensity of either team, on the boards especially.
We've seen a lot of great players here today. Remember, fans, to pick up your ballot, vote for the best player in the ACC. And the Pepsi Diet Pepsi ACC Sweepstakes, you have a chance to win a 1990 Pontiac or tickets for the ACC tournament. Ball's knocked away from Hasanovic. Hurley's got it back in the paint. Williams takes it away as Hurley tried to feed Alahabdelnabi.
Great hand.
Laettner knocks it out of bounds. Ball will belong to Maryland. What happened back up the other end, though, Phil Henderson had fallen down, and Bobby Hurley ran right over him and fell down, too. It was like a pileup of Duke players right in front of our broadcast there. Williams. Ball goes out off the arm of Evers Burns, the freshman from Baltimore, just in the game for Maryland. Duke will have it. Greg Kubak in for the first time in the second half.
Laettner takes a seat. Abdelnaby becomes more important, as does Henderson's outside shot.
The Maryland lead, as you see, is at 8. It was at 5 at halftime. It has been as large as 10 today. Henderson. He's had a tough time shooting the basketball today. Thomas Hill has not had a bad time shooting it. He's picked up some of the slack.
The board work, that's what got that hoop. That's what got the hoop. Hill on the board, Abdelnaby on the board.
And Phil Henderson's going to be called for the foul on Walt Williams. Phil Henderson has just scored 4 points today, well below his 17.7 per game average.
See a little huddle that's become so famous at Duke on every free throw. Here they go to the man-to-man on the out-of-bounds, which more and more teams are going to. Used to be that all that played was zone on the out-of-bounds.
Williams fell down, was able to pass it before he did. McCoy for three. That's only McCoy's second bucket of the game, but it's a big one. Maryland back up by 9 points. Thomas Hill, he's been red hot. He's got 11 points today. In the paint.
Push on Williams, that's his fourth. Big call. Push from behind, Walt Williams' fourth foul. Not a real smart play. He has to come out of the lineup now.
And 11:55 to play.
Yeah.
It's a very, very big play because Walt Williams has been such a key to Maryland's lead. 11:55 to play. Maryland leads it 62-53. Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon back with you in College Park. Maryland leads at 62-53. Stay tuned for Holly Farms Player of the Game Awards, brought to you by Holly Farms, America's number one brand of fresh chicken. And that's not going to be an easy selection at all in this game. Look at the turnover statistics, Terry, the difference between the first and second half.
Well, I'm sure at halftime, both coaches talked about that. When you have 14 and 12 in the first half, that's kind of unacceptable.
Thomas Hill, he's got a lot of playing time, and he has been red hot. Hill is open. And Hill hits again.
You know, and great decision by Ala Abdelnaby. He had the ball down low, drew a crowd. He had a choice, whether to go to Hurley or to Hill. Hill's been hot. He gave it out to him.
Hill's got 13 points so far in the game. Mustaf. Strong move inside. And he's got 17.
They need Laettner back in there. Kubek having trouble guarding the big guy down low.
Kubek is open.
He got hit, too. No call.
Duke is not letting Maryland pull away at all, despite Maryland's fantastic shooting from the field. Blue Devils are hanging in there. Mustaf again, he gets loose inside.
Well, they get the ball down low. You've got Walt Williams out of the game. That's when Duke made their run in the first half. So with Mike Anderson in there, I'm sure Gary Williams said, look, we've got to go down low every single time.
Anderson tries to drive by Vince Broadnax, and Broadnax, you see in your screen, is going to be called for the personal foul. Mustaf, Terry, 9 of 13 on the game. He's got 19 points. That's Broadnax's third personal. And I'm sure one of Mike Krzyzewski's worries is finding out a way to stop now Jerrod Mustaf and not just Tony Massenberg inside.
Yeah, it's tough, though. I mean, it's, you know, if you had the answer to that, they wouldn't be great players like they are in this league.
Phil Henderson has been largely silent today. Hits a three-pointer. And the Maryland lead now is down to 6 points.
Good pressure.
Henderson created the steal, and he gets it back. Just like that, two buckets for Phil Henderson, and Duke is now within 4 points of the Maryland Terrapins.
With Williams out, they've got to really take care of the basketball. Treat it like it's gold. Every possession, and get it inside as they do right there. They got fouled, but McCoy and whoever else is playing out in the guard spot, whether it be Broadnax out there handling the ball or Mike Anderson when he's in there, really the next 4 or 5 minutes until they can get Williams back in the game, they've got to take care of the ball.
That's the second personal foul on Thomas Hill, who you see coming out of the game. Robert Bricky is in to replace him. That dunk by Henderson off the turnover a moment ago, that was the first turnover of this half for Maryland. Big, big part of this basketball game.
Sure.
Maryland taking care of the basketball.
And pushing and shoving underneath, as will happen when the game gets tight.
If Laettner's called for the foul, it'll be four.
That's where you try to hide right after you do it. You wish there was just some place to go hide right there so the official couldn't see your number.
No, it'll be on Robert Bricky. It'll be the second foul on Bricky.
Ooh, big sigh of relief from the Duke bench.
Massenberg to the line. At 18 points, 7 rebounds, 19 with the free throw.
Massenberg is talent, a guy who I think will play in the NBA, maybe a high second round draft choice.
Has over 1,000 points in his career here at Maryland. That's 7 rebounds. He's now 1 rebound away from 600 in his career. He's got 599. Almost had 600 there a moment ago. Here comes Martin from Maryland. Martin on the feed to Jerrod Mustaf. Maryland really clicking on the offensive end of the floor today.
Great decision by Jesse Martin that time. Here's the run. Here's the Maryland run. Laettner that time took the shot and just fell back. Nobody around the offensive board for Duke.
The other boys were right in the hands of Ala Abdelnaby.
Nowhere to go.
Bill Henderson misses the shot, but he's fouled. Terry, if Bill Henderson could get going offensively here down the stretch of this basketball game, as Christian Laettner really upset about something inside. There's been a lot of pushing and shoving, and I guess in a game like this, tempers sometimes do get a little short as the big guys start trying to muscle each other around, and they all have so much talent.
Yeah, and I think also for Duke, as you see, Robert Bricky just trying to counsel him, say, hey, we need you this last 9 minutes and 12 seconds. Don't go off the deep end here. But for Duke, they feel like this is really an important game. At least I think they do, because they don't want to go on a losing streak. Sometimes when you go on the road, you know, they were playing at home, number 3 in the country. They were playing so well. They lose to Virginia. This is a big game for them to just turn it around, because they've got 2 games against Stetson and East Carolina they figure to win.
Henderson has 10 points on the day. the senior from University Park, Illinois. Hard to think where Duke would have been without Phil Henderson, who almost didn't come back to Duke this year. But those two free throws and Phil Henderson's points have kept Duke in this basketball game despite some extremely hot shooting on the part of the Maryland Terrapins. You see Thomas Hill coming back in. He's getting a lot of minutes in this game. He's got 13 points today. Anderson to Broadnax. Broadnax thrown by Robert Bricky. And Bricky's going to be called for the foul.
Just stuck the leg out. Nice drive by Broadnax. Very important for Maryland right now. Gary Williams up. He hasn't sat down the whole day. Hasn't taken his jacket off, though, like I thought he would. But Maryland against Clemson had a 13-point lead in the second half and blew it here at home. So I'm sure that's in the back of their mind somewhere, as Duke is a team who plays tough man-to-man defense. They come after you, and they made the run the other night against Virginia.
Vince Broadnax has not scored today. Has now, as Terry told us in the first half, was awarded a scholarship a couple of weeks ago. Walked on here in Maryland, junior from Forestville. Gary, Maryland refuses to let Duke cut this lead under 6 or 8 points.
Duke keeps coming back at him, though. The work on the board, that's what's kept him in it.
Hurley inside. Tony Massenberg was called for leaning on the back of Christian Laettner. As you said, there is a lot of pushing going on. I think officials sometimes let a little bit of that go by, but then again, you can only do so much.
Well, the ACC, they've got the best officials anywhere. I don't care what you say. And all you want, really, is consistency. I mean, if they're going to call one foul at the beginning of the game, you want them to call the same foul at the end. And I think they've been pretty consistent here today. They've allowed some pushing to go on down underneath, but at least the players know what they can and can't get away with.
Christian Laettner has hit his average in points today. He's also cut the Maryland lead down to 7. Laettner, a tough physical player inside. He's really shown it today, battling Massenberg and Mustaf underneath the basket.
Only a sophomore. Great touch from the outside. He said physical inside. Going to be a talent. Already is.
Broadnax works against Henderson. Henderson got a hand on the ball and knocked it out of bounds.
Somebody's got to come meet the basketball. Real important right now for the big guys, if the guard is in trouble out there with the pressure defense, to come post to the basketball. Don't stay down low. They need some help.
Good man-to-man defense on the part of Duke. Ala Abdelnaby says he knocked it out off of Mustaf. Larry Limbo says, Ala, you knocked it out.
Good. Larry won the argument.
Broadnax, good pass inside. When you get it down low in the paint to Mustaf like that, Terry, as you said, it's either going to be 2 points or a foul. That time it was a foul.
Hang it up. That's all you can do. They're having trouble, as they do all day. What Maryland does is they run a little cut down low. They interchange and run a screen where a guy comes to the block and comes and posts up on the block. And they're having trouble down low guarding that. Whether they want to switch or stay with their man, they're just not getting it done.
Jerrod Mustaf, what a great game he's had today. 21 points, 10 of 14 shooting from the field. Missed the free throw. He also has 5 rebounds to his credit. Mustaf, the sophomore from Greenbelt, Maryland, played at DeMatha High School. .22 to play in a basketball game. 73-66, as you see. The Maryland crowd starting to get back into this game. Laettner with 2 for Duke.
Set up by Hurley, the penetration and the dish. Hasn't done a whole lot of that today. They've played him well.
Christian Laettner looks as he's going to be the go-to guy down the stretch for the Big Blue Devils.
Nice. Nice by Massenberg. That's where the big guys got to come out for a release.
Mustaf, short. Massenberg, another rebound. and a bucket. That's just a fantastic play by a great basketball player.
Shouldn't surprise you. He's done it all year long and all day long.
Tony Massenberg today, 22 points, 9 rebounds. Abdelmabel,
off the glass. Yep.
Credits the bucket to Ala Abdelmabel. Goaltending is called on Tony Massenberg. What a game he's played. 22 points, 9 rebounds. Now a word from our good friends at Natural Light. Mike Hogwood and Terry Gannon back with you in College Park. Maryland leads Duke by 5, 7:28 to play in this game. As we get prepared for the stretch run, Duke in close games. Terry 4-3 in games decided by 10 points or less.
So it's about even, which mainly tells you that they've outscored their opponents by a wide margin most of the time. They've outscored them by 17 points. That's the average margin of victory for Duke.
Duke has only lost 4 games all year. Good speed inside of Massenberg. He's got the bucket and the foul. Tony Massenberg having one of the best games of his career today.
Yeah, I mean, how many times is they going to do it? You know, it's like a repeat. We can take it one time, just play it over and over again. Massenberg just used his body as Duke tried to overplay him. See, Laettner's on top. Abdelnaby's got to help quicker. He's got to help and get there while the ball is up in the air. He gets there a little bit late. He's got contact, and Massenberg makes the shot. He's got to get there right away.
Tony Massenberg, 25 points today, 9 rebounds. One career mark he's bested today. He's gone over the 600 rebound mark in his career. Well, the all-time greats here at the University of Maryland. You're seeing him play this afternoon. Number 25, Tony Massenberg.
Back to his zone now for Maryland. He's got to keep an eye on Henderson and Hurley.
Henderson, that shot was bothered by Brodnack. Almost went in anyway.
The tendency right now for Maryland, you're up 8, but there's 6.5 minutes left in the game. You can't get tentative. Keep doing the things you've been doing like that.
Oh, my! This crowd here in College Park loves him. Tony Massenberg, 6'9", senior from Sussex, Virginia. And can he play the game of round ball?
At a third M. Machine, that's what he's been today. He's been a machine. Give him the ball down there and just let him go. Turn the switch on and watch him.
He's got 27 points, 10 rebounds. That's his 8th double-double of the season. They got 28 points now. That's also the largest Maryland lead of the day. It's at 11, 81-70.
They haven't won here since 1985 against this Duke team.
Thomas Hill. I think Thomas Hill is making his presence felt on this Duke basketball team. Played a great game a couple of weeks ago against Wake Forest.
Yeah, great first half.
7 of 8 from the field today, 15 points for Thomas Hill.
Hurley's doing a great job on T.M. McCoy. He finally gets the ball, but he was overplaying him, making it really tough for him to handle it.
McCoy's been really held down in this offense today, but he hasn't had the score because of this guy, Messenger. Mustaf with the ball outside. And he took one too many going to the hole that time.
He feels like he got hit on the drive, but if it was in the NBA, he'd have been okay with it. Watch it right here. Does he get hit on the drive right here? A little bit of contact. Nah, nothing to call. Just takes one extra step. Throw that thing up there a little sooner. You'll be okay.
5:45. The clock starting to wind down now. And become a factor in this game. Laettner. Boy, I'll tell you, when you're on the road and things aren't going your way, you do things like miss layups.
Can't buy one right now.
McCoy put his head down, tried to beat Bobby Hurley. Hurley trying to hold his position, and the foul is going to be called on Bobby Hurley.
That's a tough call. I think it's a pretty good call, but if you're a defender, you're Hurley, and you're moving your feet. He didn't use his hands at all. Watch him. He did a great job getting his feet in front. You try to beat him to the spot, and you just get behind him a little bit. I don't know.
You know, if you call that one, you're going to have to call a lot of them, and that's his fourth foul. He goes to the bench. He moved his feet pretty well.
I think it's safe to say Bobby Hurley has had a fairly frustrating afternoon here. Four personal fouls. He'll try to regroup, get his thoughts together. I'm sure he'll be back in a moment.
You know, the funny thing is, in the second half, unlike the first half, when Williams went out, they extended the lead here in the second half.
His first presence here in the second half of this game. And inside the Laettner. Massenberg knocks the ball away. As if he hasn't done enough already, he comes up with a big defensive play. Lewis.
Ragtag basketball. Get it back out and set it up. Smart decision.
Bill Henderson will be called for a personal foul as Walt Williams gets ready to come back into the Maryland lineup. You mentioned the schedule earlier, and all the teams they've lost to have been pretty good teams, too.
Great team. I mean, Syracuse, when they came on the floor in that Big East shootout, I thought it was a pro team. That's how big they were. Michigan on the road. That was a great game in overtime. Carolina, we all remember that game at the Dean Dome, and then the game Thursday night against Virginia.
Keon McCoy, 5 points today. As he hits the first free throw. And certainly we're not counting Duke out of this game today. 4:56 to play, that's a lot of time. And Duke has made up 10 or more points before in this amount of time.
Like Thursday night.
Exactly. Maryland back up to their largest lead again at 11. Christian Laettner for three. Lewis, I believe, will be called for the foul inside. Cedric Lewis, a junior from Temple Hills, Maryland. And Cedric will be coming out as Jerrod Mustaf, who was out of the game for just about a minute and a half just to get a blow and get ready for this stretch run, I'm sure, is back in.
Laettner not able to hit that three-point shot. Right there after he shot it in the break, Bricky told him to get it up more, use your legs, and he's right. Everything's been short from the outside from Laettner.
Robert Bricky cans the first free throw.
And obviously when you're tired, that's what happens. You got to get more leg drive in your shot. If you're missing left or right, then you've got to change something. There's something wrong. But if you're missing short or long, you make the adjustment not in the upper half of your body, but in the lower half, your legs.
Robert Bricky, who missed 8 games with that knee injury, still not at full strength, but out of there giving it everything he's got to try to pull out a win for Duke. Jesse Martin works against McCaffrey. Great pass inside of Mustaf.
Well, they are just executing against the pressure defense. I mean, we couldn't do it any better.
Laettner looks at a three. Oh, my! Christian Laettner on the way to the floor. Hit that bucket.
He was parallel to the floor when he threw that up there.
Not only have the big guys played well, Terry, but I think the other guys done such a wonderful job of getting the ball down low to them. People like Walt Williams and Jesse Martin. He's fouled by Robert Bricky as he went up.
Right. When there's pressure on the basketball, it's very hard to get a pass down low, and Duke does such a good job of that. So you don't just give credit to the inside guys, but the guards as well, as you said, getting it down low. It's been a great job.
That was the fourth personal foul on Robert Bricky. Martin to the line. 4 for 4 today. Make it 5 for 5. Thomas Hill's back in the game. Robert Bricky will lead.
Obviously, now it's a free throw contest. The last 3 minutes and 58 seconds. If Maryland hits their free throws, they win.
Jesse Martin's done a good job of that today. He's hit all of them.
That's happened like 3 times today. Everyone's anticipating that and getting a leg in the lane early.
Tony Massenberg just stuck a foot in there. 3:58 to play. Can Duke come back? Right now, they trail it by 10. Maryland leads 86-76.
You want to see it happen just like they drew it up on the blackboard in the locker room? Check this out. As Duke cheats right here, watch Bricky go to double team Jesse Martin. The no-look pass inside, always thinking inside. Perfect pass. He turns, and you're never going to stop him when he gets it down on the block. And they've done that all day long, Mike. Talk about points in the paint. For Duke, 16 in the first half, only 8 in the second half, 25 and 28 for Maryland. You need not look more than that if you want the story of this ballgame.
Massenberg and Mustaf, what a pair those two have been today. Every time Duke has threatened to cut this Maryland lead down, Maryland has responded. Ball hit the sideline, it will belong to Maryland. The Terrapins lead it by 10. And you get the feeling that Duke is going to make a serious run at this game pretty soon. They have got to start coming up with some points.
Well, yeah, obviously. And a couple steals down here. If they go another minute, they've got to start fouling. So they're going to try to get steals for the next minute or so, and then they've got to reserve for the foul. There you go.
Here's a steal right there. Bobby Hurley gets it away to Brian Davis. Henderson's open. Davis finally sees him. It was like a lone wide receiver, and the quarterback never saw him. After a while, Davis hit. Here's another steal. Bobby Hurley. He's fouled.
Gary Williams might get a quick timeout. Two quick steals by Duke, and they're getting back in this ball game. Here you go, a timeout. Good timeout. Good steal by Hurley once again. Heads up play. Gets fouled going to the hoop. Duke will do that to you. They come after you.
The Duke Blue Devils are making a move. 3:16 to play. A word from our good friends now at Natural Light.
ACC basketball has been brought to you by Pepsi, Food Lion, Ford, and by First Union National Bank.
Bobby Hurley will be going to the free throw line. What's Gary Williams telling his Maryland Terrapins during that timeout, Terry?
Well, I think as you look at the free throw shooting stats, he said in that timeout, look, you've handled the pressure all game long. Don't put more pressure on yourself just because we're down in the last 3 minutes of the game. You've handled it all game long. You know you can do it. Just relax and do it.
Bobby Hurley, almost an 80% free throw shooter. Freshman from Jersey City, New Jersey. Hits them both. The lead was 10. It's now 6. Full court pressure by Duke. They've got a quick team on the floor, too. This is Walt Williams. Bring it up against Bill Henderson. Coming up to the 3-minute mark.
Yep.
Is that a turnover? Yes. Yes, it is.
Right between the legs of Jesse Martin. Right in front of Gary Williams.
Maryland has had 3 consecutive turnovers now. Sure, Gary Williams is hollering for them to regain their composure just a bit. Laettner inside. Walt Williams will be called for the foul. Laettner will go to the line with 2 shots.
And that's the mark of a team who knows what they're doing. You look at the free throw stats. Christian Laettner, 86.7. Hey, who do you foul in there? No one. I mean, look at all those guys. Over 75%, 77.6% as a team. Third in the nation. They're great at the line, and it's the mark of a team who knows what they're doing. They came down after the steal. They set up a play for Laettner to get it down low, and they executed.
Walt Williams has fouled out. 13 points today, 6 rebounds. We just hollered some encouragement to his replacement, Mike Anderson. Laettner here will try to cut the Maryland lead down to 4. It was 10, 86-76.
That's a lot of pressure on Mike Anderson, too, coming in. Look at the Duke bench. They never gave up today. They kept coming after him on the boards, on the defensive end. They're a team that can really make some runs at you because of their defense, and they're doing it right now.
You saw the eyes, the blue eyes of Christian Laettner concentrating on those free throws. He hit them both, and that lead is 4.
It's all on his shoulders right now. He's the point guard in there. Williams is out. Mike Anderson, with not a lot of experience, he's got to handle the pressure.
Remember, he has not played competitive basketball before this season for about 4 or 5 years. That'll take some of the pressure off right there. Jerrod Mustaf. Another bucket down low. Jesse Martin whistles for the foul inside.
Lucky there was a backstop, a padded backstopper. He and Henderson would have ended up in the third row. Nice pass inside by Anderson. Here you go with Mustaf down low. They can't quite get there with the double team, and he has a little jump hook. But credit Anderson with handling the pressure and getting the ball inside.
Jerrod Mustaf has 26 points today. He and Massenberg have been a good part of the offense. Larry Limbo is over conferring at the scoring table about some confusion.
Both teams in the bonus. They'll be at the line. I'm not real sure what they said over there, but I know Gary Williams telling his bench. I mean, those guys catch it all game long, even when they're sitting on the bench, more than when they're out on the court.
We've been told, Terry, that Robert Bricky actually reported in for Phil Henderson, and then someone else left, and Bricky's in the game. Henderson's on the foul line.
Yeah, a little confusion there, but he changed his mind.
It's all straight now, and Phil Henderson hits the free throw.
Sure.
And our big story is that it's now a Maryland 5-point lead. It was 5 points at halftime. It was 10 points just a minute ago. The lead is now 4. And again, Walt Williams, the point guard for Maryland, is fouled out of the game.
Hurley, a great job on Anderson.
Bricky almost stole it from Mustaf.
He better get it up.
Mustaf turns it over. Here comes Duke. The Blue Devils putting on a great comeback. Henderson in the lane. Henderson hits. What a performance by the Duke Blue Devils. Terry, you see there why they are on top in the ACC. What a job they have done from being 10 points down. Now to cut it down to 2. Super, super play on the part of the Duke Blue Devils.
Well, they did it on the defensive end, too. And that's something that Maryland does not do well. They haven't done it well all year long. They do it better now than they used to, but that is handle the basketball. And there's so much pressure here in the last 3 minutes. A Walt Williams goes out. You've got Mike Anderson in there. Hurley doing a great job denying the ball, denying him the basketball. He can't get his hands on it. That time, Mustaf had to bring it up against the pressure. It was too much for him.
At the 4-minute mark of this game, Maryland led 86-76. Since then, Terry, Duke's been on a 10-2 run. Maryland has had 4 turnovers in their last 5 possessions.
You know, they did such a great job all game long of handling the ball. Right now, the pressure's a little, it's pushed up a little more. It's full court pressure, and they don't have Williams in there. That's the problem.
Well, what is Mike Krzyzewski telling his players now? Obviously, they have to keep up the defensive pressure.
He's saying, whatever you're doing, keep it up. Keep doing it. They made that run. You know, obviously, defensively, they want to pressure the basketball as much as they can. Keep it away from Anderson. He's the one guy who really handles the rock well in there now. And Gary Williams is saying, spread the court. I think you may see someone go long here. They're denying the basketball inbounds. You may see someone go long for a pass.
2 minutes, 18 seconds left to play. Maryland leads by 2. This is Mike Anderson, football player. Hasn't played since basketball when he was in high school. Now a senior. Turnover again. Thomas Hill takes away from Jesse Martin. Here's Henderson. Tricky with the follow. And our game is tied. 1:58 to play. It is all tied at 88.
Wow. Simply wow. I mean, what a comeback. And what a run.
That is the first tie since we were tied at 5 early in the game today.
Somebody's got to help him now. There you go.
Bricky with a steal. Robert Bricky.
And
it'll count, and the foul will be on Tony Massenberg. What a play by Robert Bricky, who has worked so hard to come back from that knee injury and has listened to everybody say that he is not 100%. And I'll tell you one thing, this is nothing but hustle and desire right here, Terry Gannon.
Bounce pass on the perimeter, it's a tough pass. Ricky, great quickness getting to the basketball and one down here at this end. And you talk about a change in the juice going from Maryland to Duke, I mean, so quickly.
And Tony Massenberg is fouled out. I believe Tony Massenberg has 5 fouls, he does. Tony Massenberg fouls out with 28 points. Great game today for Tony Massenberg, but I'm sure he'd trade in all those 28 points for a Maryland lead right now.
No doubt about that. It'll be tough from here on out. You got Williams on the bench, you've got Massenberg on the bench.
So we've had Massenberg and Walt Williams, the foul out. Robert Brickey, who's had 4 points in the last 20 seconds.